Hello, friends of the Northern Entertainment, and welcome to another episode of my ETS2. Today we are in ETS2 multiplayer, and we are driving for a cause. As you can see here, it is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and it is day two of the big SCS event, hashtag Pink My Truck. As you can see, they have custom paint jobs for the trucks as well as for the trailers. The trailers are free. The trucks, if you want the paint job for the truck, that will cost you, well, it's $2.50 Canadian, and I do believe 100% of that go towards cancer research. And you know what? This is one of the things. This is one of those sicknesses or ailments, really, where I say that's the great equalizer, because cancer doesn't care who you are. Cancer doesn't care what you think you are, how famous you are, how insignificant you think you are. It just doesn't care. That's why I always say it's the great equalizer, and everybody knows at least one person, I can guarantee you, that is affected by this. Be that breast cancer or any kind of cancer, really. That being said, let's get started. Let's get rolling here. Of course, thank you to my sponsors from Thrustmaster. If you are curious what I'm using, I say that every time, but every time I get the same question, what are you using? Well, so I will tell you again. I am using, for trucking, I'm using the TSX Base together with the Sparco R383 rim when it comes to the wheel. The TX, since I bought the leather edition, is coming with the paddles. I forgot what the paddles are called. Will be in the description below though. And I have also the Thrustmaster shifter, which I don't necessarily use when I'm driving Euro trucks, because, well, trucks in Europe don't have really shifters anymore in them. Well, they do have shifters, but they are all automatic, so you don't have an actual shifter anymore. As for everything auxiliary, that's all here handled by the button box and my quote-unquote virtual reality, which is, of course, it's not virtual reality. It just helps you a little bit with finding your bearings. That's all handled by Track IR, by the Track IR from Natural Point. That all set, yeah, welcome to the stream. We are, as I said, on multiplayer. We are in Italy, and we're gonna take the scenic route, I figured, because we have a lot to talk about. We have a lot to talk about in terms of upcoming videos. We have a lot to talk about in terms of my dreams and aspirations when it comes to YouTube. Also, we have to talk about my return to YouTube when it comes to streaming. How, why, when. And yeah, so I figure it's gonna be a nice drive. We're gonna make it. Aha, see, we did make it. Was still yellow. I am driving the recently released Renault Range T. A beautiful, beautiful truck, I might add. Yep, honk that horn, my boy, honk that horn. Maybe turn that light on. There we go. Keep right and then exit right. So as I said, we are going to Torino. Oh, I don't know if I said that we are going to Torino, but we are going to Torino. And and no. And we were a little bit fast there. No, honestly, I have the trailer stability way too low, because I was going 45. There should have been no way that this trailer is starting to tip. I was actually hoping that I could get it back up. But, how am I gonna get off this now? No, but I was hoping that I could get the trailer back upright. Unfortunately, of course, as you clearly have seen, that did not work so well. Gonna reduce the speed here to 30-ish, or around 40 you can usually go through those automatic ones. But at 40 it's hit and miss, literally. But yeah, let's start at the beginning. Why am I back on YouTube for streaming? Well, I'm not gonna go into why I'm not going back to Twitch. That topic, kinda, we beat that one to death. You guys know what I think in terms of my future on Twitch and or my unfuture on Twitch. And you know, it kinda hurts, of course, because I'm walking away from almost $300 a month. Close to 400, depending on how many subscribers you have. And of course, with me wanting to become a full-time content creator at some point, that is my aspiration. Whether or not it's realistic, that doesn't matter, but that's the goal. And I will, in later, I can absolutely go over why I would like to be a content creator. However, Twitch and I, we don't see eye to eye in a lot of things anymore. They decided that their policies are the way they are, and that's perfectly fine. They are a corporation. They have to figure out in the end what makes them the most money. That's just the way it goes. I know that. But surprised that the radio is so silent. But I decided to move on from there. And I think I hit the ceiling. I went as far as I could go on Twitch. The partnership, that's just not meant for me. And that's fine, because I have everything really that I need already in YouTube. I have my verification, I have my follower base of over 100,000. Coming back here to YouTube the last little while from Mixer, after I tried that for 2 weeks, 2.5 weeks, really showed that that's where I'm supposed to be. I mean, it is, as I said, it's scary to walk away from Twitch because of the money that's gone. But I think over time I can make that up and then some when I stay on YouTube. And yes, I do have to think about money, although this is just a side gig, but the internet alone is almost $200 a month. And that's not including, there is a lot more that goes to running a channel if you run it properly than what meets the eye. But that's neither here or there, and I'm not complaining at all. I'm just telling you guys. The thing with Mixer was, however, you guys know I was like, oh, well, I'm going to try Mixer because the partner requirements are not very high compared to others. And maybe that's where I'm supposed to be with my streaming. And I know I went a lot back and forth, and I do apologize for that. I did apologize for that on Twitter already, profusely, as well as on Discord. So now I'm gonna do it officially here also on this video, or in this video. I do apologize for all the back and forth that we had the last little while. But if you try to push your channel ahead and try new things, then sometimes you go down the wrong road, and all you can do at that point is, well, either you keep on going down that wrong road, but for me personally, I realized that if I do that, I'm gonna be left with nothing. Because by the time I can turn this thing around, if I keep going as long as I wanted to go, my initial goal or my initial set date was by the end of the year, I wanted to see how far we got on Mixer. However, when you have so and so many people watch you, like when the views drop from about 60 per stream to about 15, and of those 15, over 50%, okay, we have to quickly change something here. Of those 15, 50% have technical issues to the point that they can't have any visual anymore. All they have is audio, and even that doesn't really work. Well, then it's time to reassess the situation. And for me, it was really, it was very, very apparent that while many said we would love to see you still, and I mean, I ran the poll and over 2,000 of you guys, over 2,000 voted. 78% of those 2,000 people said, come back to YouTube, we can't watch you on Mixer. So, here we are. Fast forward 4 days later, since I made the decision that I'm gonna abandon Project Mixer because it just isn't meant for me, apparently. Yeah, back on YouTube, and I have to say it was a good decision because the average numbers on the streams are right where they're supposed to be, or they are getting where they're supposed to be. Yeah, it might be tiny in terms of actual view numbers compared to subscribers that I have, but on that same token, we know that not everybody who's subscribed to a channel will watch the live streams, especially with the times that I'm streaming at, because of work, because of family. I'm streaming at times, and I know that very well, that are not very very advantageous in terms of growing the channel. That being said, I will keep doing what I'm doing right now, and I will bring you guys the best content that I can bring. I aspire to be a full-time creator. Why do I aspire to be a full-time creator? That is twofold. One is because I just think that I'm good at what I'm doing. And that's not me being conceited. That's me just being assessing where I am today and assessing my advancement, if you will, from the days when I started YouTube to now. There is progress. There's definitely progress. And I just think that that's where I'm supposed to be in the end. Now, I'm doing my darndest to get to there. I will need you guys to help me to get to there, because in the end, it's just with an actor. If you are an actor and nobody watches your movies, then you are out of a job. And so it is for a YouTube creator as well. If you are a creator and nobody watches your videos, then you can create all day long. It won't do you a heck of a lot of good. Because, well, if nobody watches you, then you're not going to be creating. Or you're going to be creating, but
okay, let's find a new route.
You're going to be creating for yourself. Oh, wait a second. I was like, oh, let's quickly skip ahead here with the night. Have a little sleep, drive during the daytime. But that, of course, is not an option since we are driving online. And, yeah, as I said, there is also the point that I do believe in the bottom of my heart that I'm supposed to be a creator, because unlike what I ever thought was possible, or unlike what I ever thought I would be able to do. Yeah, the recent years showed that my videos make a big impact on people. The ones that watch it. And you guys tell me that over and over and over in messages, be that PM, be that DMs on Discord or emails, or on Facebook, or you name it, on all the outlets. And it's very humbling, but at the same time, I feel like I could reach so much more, or reach so many more, make such, a bigger impact if I do this full-time. But of course, doing this full-time, at my age, where I am in life, means that I have to make a significant amount of money with this. And that's, again, where you come in, is by not activating your ad block. And I do believe to be transparent. I always was transparent in these things with you guys. There will be a transitional time where I have my... Oh, that's pretty much the time right now where I have my day job. And also have the side income. Which will grow over time. But there is this, will be this transitional time where I have a significant income from YouTube as well as a significant income from my day job. And I have ideas what I will do in this time. I'm not gonna disclose that yet because I have to talk to a couple more people in high places if the ideas that I have are feasible. But let's just say that I'm planning on giving back to the community in a big way in this transitional phase. And I will see how it all works out. So you might wonder, since we are going to Torino, how in the world, why are we going towards Parma? What's going on? You are driving the complete wrong way, if you know these routes. Well, that is true. But as I said in the beginning of the video, we are really taking the scenic route on this one. Because I figured, it is just a nice thing to drive through Italy's hinterland, if you will. And plus, it's a nice quiet drive, usually even with over 4,000 people on the multiplayer server. As soon as you get to the point, yeah, Italy and whatnot, it seems to be a fairly quiet part of the map at best times. Yeah, about this event, that's another thing that I wanted to talk to you guys about is I'm really excited about the events that World of Trucks makes for us. And I think we have to take a minute to really thank the guys from SES, to really thank the guys that are behind the World of Trucks to pull all those events off. And I'm still, to this day, I am a little bit miffed and annoyed with myself because the only event that I ever missed of all the World of Truck events since their inception was 2016's gift delivery, and I'm still annoyed. I mean, I think the personal goal on ETS. Yeah, that was ETS only back then, I think. There was no ATS event. Was ATS even out? 2016? I can't even remember. Holy cow. Well, I'm sure somebody will let me know in the description below. I'm sure of that. But, yeah, I don't know what was going on, but I did not have the time. And I forgot about it, and then by the time I remembered, it was all over. That event was history by that time. That doesn't happen anymore. Especially with this event, it's really easy because it's just 12 total. 12 deliveries total. In past events, it was like, okay, if you want whatever you can get by finishing the event for your decorations or paint job or whatever the case may be. In ATS, you have to have sold so many loads in ATS, and if you want it in ETS, then you have to have sold so many loads in ETS. This time though, with this event, it's a combined effort. So it's 12 loads, ETS and ATS combined, and however you want to split those up, you can do so, which is really nice. I also just realized that I forgot to turn on the overlay that shows you guys where I'm going and how long we have left. So I will tell you, it's 168 kilometers left to go, which is really not that long. So that means that I was correct with my assumption that driving through the hinterland is a good idea.
Keep right and then exit right.
Although the real hinterland, it will be starting here right away once we are off the autobahn. That's when we go through the twisties and turnies. I do have to say, I really like the dashboard on this, on the Range T. Like, if you are speeding and you tell me you didn't know, then I have to say, liar, liar, pants on fire. Because look at the size of this thing. I mean, there's no way you don't know how fast you're going. Yeah, buddy. Sure. Fortunately, I didn't understand what you were saying, but that's okay. Huh? Oh. Right. I still have my retarder activated. Jack Black, Germany. Interesting. I lost all my momentum. Very annoying. Well, this is now the second time that I told you guys the wrong destination. We are going to Bologna. 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 Not Bologna. Bologna. Yeah, I don't even know why I was thinking Torino. But anyways, doesn't really matter. Because we'll just keep going. And I got the display now on, as you can see. I quickly took a breather there. Honk. That's a very relaxing drive though. Ancona. Oh yeah, once we get off the highway, that's when the fun part starts. And then exit right. That's what I was looking forward the most, is driving over those little roads, over those little twisty turny roads. There we go. Oh, I'm curious.
Keep right and then exit right.
I am rather curious how this is all gonna continue now. But yeah, I do have to say that I am indeed really, really, really humbled by the absolutely overwhelmingly positive response that I'm back on YouTube streaming. I mean, the amount of people that came in, especially what's really nice, and I said that during the stream, I'm an idiot. Well, I said that too during the stream once or twice, but what's really nice for me always is to see... when I see people that I haven't seen in a long time all of a sudden pop up again in streams. That was so silly of me. I should have gone through the express. I don't know what I was thinking there. but A. Emsland transported. Oh, look at that. Well, somehow my whole nice little plan of going through the hinterland, if you will, didn't quite work out. Somehow my GPS was smarter than I was. Or not. But either way. Either way, we are now coming here into Bologna already. Or Bologna? Bologna? I think Bologna. I don't know. I'm not Italian. I'm guessing. Sometimes I guess right. Sometimes I guess wrong. Exomar. I think that's where we're delivering to, don't we? Oh, great. Another roundabout. I love roundabouts. Not really. Mm-hmm, that's the plan. Well, friends, I guess that's already the end of our little drive. I do hope you enjoyed the time that we spent here in the cab. Turn left. Taking the virtual highways under our wheels. I don't think I got to talk about everything that I wanted to talk about, but I think I got the major points covered. And if you have any comments, any ideas, any suggestions, then by all means, leave them in the comments below. And I am looking forward to the next time already. Tonight, we will be driving more here for this event in Euro Truck Multiplayer. So you are more than welcome to join me there. And yeah, until next time. It is all over now, she is correct. But until next time, I say thank you so much for watching, guys. I say that already, albeit I have no idea how long we gonna spend trying to park this thing. Ah, that looks like a fairly simple approach though, especially with the Euro Truck. Those things turn on a dime compared to our North American machines. I still think it would be pretty cool to see. And if you have a VR device, then you probably can attest to that. I know Jeff was saying, how amazing it is when you drive with an actual headset, VR headset. How amazing the scale is, how much that really... Oh, you know what? How much that really makes a difference. And I messed that one up. There we go. Cut it a little bit too early, unfortunately. Sometimes that happens. But overall, a good drive. Definitely an interesting drive with that little tippy action there in the beginning. But that all being said, thank you everybody for watching. I do hope you enjoyed this drive. And until next time, Northern Alex signing off. God bless.